So there's some really interesting history when it comes to statistics. Some of it is not very nice. We'll talk about that. I think it's also important to note that the science of statistics revolutionized science, and that before we had an understanding of how to analyze data and how to design experiments, everyone kind of did it their own way. And so it was really hard to make raw judgments about things. And so having a framework like statistics really helped push the field of science, all fields of science, forward. But there are some dark histories behind statistics and behind statisticians. So I'm going to tell a little story. This has to do with our understanding of regression today. So in the 1870s, there was a gentleman named Francis Galton, and he ran a lab in London that was focused on what was called biometrics, basically measuring living things. He was a man who was obsessed with measuring things, and he was obsessed with measuring people. He traveled the world measuring people. He was fascinated by pygmies in Africa, very small people, very tall people. He was fascinated by it for nefarious reasons, because he was fascinated by eugenics. A lot of early statisticians happened to be eugenicists, which is definitely a dark period in our history, in the history of statistics. But Galton wasn't all bad, right? Nobody's all bad, but Galton also did some really great things. From those measurements, he tabulated distributions and he calculated mean values. He employed legions of women as calculators. They were people who crunched these numbers for him, and they did it all without calculators, without computers. They used tabulating machines, and they used arithmetic, and they made many thousands of calculations without the help of the things that we have now that make calculating things easy. So this is where the term calculator came from, was actually the women that worked for people like Galton who were making these measurements. So one of the really interesting things that he found has to do with heredity. So he determined that abnormally small and large men tend to have offspring that are actually more average than they are. And this is before we had a clear understanding of genetic contributions. And it was before people understood that mothers had anything to do with that, right? But like, oh, maybe the mother has something to do with how tall the son ends up being, right? So it was before we understood the genetic contributions that that both sexes in a sexually reproducing species have to their offspring's phenotypes. But this tendency of very large people and very small people having children who actually tend to be more average helps human populations maintain normal distributions. It keeps them from developing bimodal distributions. So we don't end up having, you know, a population of really small people and a population of really large people. Overall, we have a normal distribution of heights in human populations. This phenomenon keeps large populations stable through time. And Galton, he termed this regression to the mean, like we were regressing toward the mean. And this is where the term regression comes from, this idea of regressing to the mean. So instead of the bimodal populations, then we end up maintaining this kind of normal population. It's why the bell-shaped curve is so common in nature, is that many populations and many structures have the same tendency. So Galton is considered the father of regression, but he made many other valuable contributions to science. We already talked about some of his unfounded and kind of vile opinions, but he rediscovered correlation analyses and he contributed to their popularity. He studied meteorology. He discovered that fingerprints are unique to individuals. And he coined the phrase nature versus nurture. So this idea of how much of what you see is due to genetics versus your environment. Galton happened to be Charles Darwin's half cousin, and his work with regression was a key finding in the field of genetics and heritability and heredity. Like many of his peers at the time, he was curious about eugenics, unfortunately. And despite that, you know, having that stain on his record, he was knighted in 1911. Another famous statistician named Ronald Elmer Fisher, was able to expand on Galton's regression concept and turn it into the statistical family of models that have dominated statistics for many years. So regression is this method of fitting a line to a cloud of points, but we calculate what's called an F value, and that F value is named after Fisher. So if you study statistics, you'll learn a lot more about R.A. Fisher, who also happened to be a eugenicist. They almost all were, unfortunately. But that doesn't mean that we can't go on and use statistics for good instead of evil.